So how do you build a team? Start with the best people you can find. Choose team members who will have a good fit. Look for members with a diversity of backgrounds and perspectives. You got to do it for any people in your organization that you want to bring in. If you have to force yourself, one thing that you got to do is you got to have the right mindset. You got to force yourself to get people on board to help you with the different areas within your organization. Amazon areas, copywriting areas, content writing. You know what? You want to do content creation. You want to do Facebook advertising, Instagram marketing, whatever it is, you got to bring people in. What will we cover today? Well, what is a team? The advantage of having a team, when we should build a team, how to do it, and then most important positions that everyone needs to hire in order to expand. So what is a team? Okay, this is a definition that is a common definition out there. A team is a group of people with a commitment to one another, to the team, to a high level of achievement, to a common goal, and to a common vision. So for example, is a freelancer a part of your team? Everybody, I want you guys to just comment, all right? Show me some life. Is a freelancer a part of your team? A group of people with a commitment to one another, to the team, to a high level of achievement, to a common goal, and to a common vision. All right. If you hire people out there to do one single task for you or for you and your organization, do they care if you expand or if you don't expand? Do they really care if they actually help you grow your business? They don't. They might be interested in doing a good job just because they want you to hire them again. But do they really care for you and your expansion in 2020 and your goals? No. I can tell you that the people in my organization, they care. They care because they know that they grow more themselves, the more that the company grows. And that's what building a team is all about. Advantages of having a team broadens what individuals can do. Several heads mean a wider range of ideas. Teams have a great array of talents and skills. Team members learn new skills from their colleagues. A team member has more ownership of what she's doing. Good teams can build leaders. A shared vision keeps everyone moving forward. When should we build a team? You have too much work on your plate. You feel like your days are actually disappearing in front of you. You actually feel like you are not getting all the stuff that you could get done every day. You go to sleep every single day and you close your computer upset because you had things to do. If you're going for that right now, you should be building a team. You know when I go for that? Every single day. That's why I'm always recruiting. Just as last week, I got 5 new people on board. I got 3 local staff and I got 5 people outside of the Philippines that are getting started shortly in the next week or two. So I'm always going for that. I always know that I could do more. I'm always building things that people can actually continue to create. You want to create a strategic plan for expanding your business, starting up a new organization or initiative, starting a new program or a new intervention, performing a particular function within a company, program, or initiative. So how do you build a team? Start with the best people you can find. Choose team members who will have a good fit. Look for members with a diversity of backgrounds and perspectives. Look for members with a commitment to the concept of working as a team. That's what you find out on these things like a video that somebody does. I can tell you some, for example, I have a guy, his name is John. John, come here so I can see you in camera. So over here. This guy right here is John, all right? When he made his videos, he's always recording me around. Now he's following me everywhere. Oh, so good. Just wanted to see you. John is recording me and he's documenting the process of AGM, my seminars, my webinars, and all kinds of stuff. When he made a video, what I saw in him was that he really wanted to be a part of a team. He wanted to be a part of something special. He decided to join the organization because he wanted to have a long-term business where he can build a career, where he can grow within it. I perceived that and I sensed that in him. And because of that, I gave him the opportunity. That's what I look for in these things. Did you guys notice that I don't like for resumes? I don't ask for resumes anywhere. Did you guys pay attention to that? I don't give a rat's ass about resume. Why? Because I don't have a resume. If you ask me for a resume, I don't know what I'm going to give you. Maybe I'll tell you, hey, well, I've sold $200 million in products and I built an organization and I have a business that went from one small bankrupt country to like 9 countries and internationally a powerhouse. And I don't have anything in writing. I don't have a resume. I never did. I never will have a resume. Because of that, I don't require that from my staff. How am I going to require something from somebody that I don't myself believe in? That's just who I am, right? I want to look at who they are, what are their passions, what are their dreams and goals, what ambitions do they have? How do they want to grow? What do they want to accomplish in life? Do they want to just flip burgers in life or do they want to go ahead and build a legacy, leave a mark behind them. And that's what I'm looking for. And that's what you guys need to look for too. You want to find that drive, that energy. If I asked Jonald back then, Jonald, tell me, what's your resume? Give me your resume. Well, I cooked Japanese meals. What does that have to do with marketing? Nothing. You know what he also did for a while? He was a customer service rep. Jonald, customer service. It's pretty funny, right? He's one of the top marketing guys for one of the top fastest growing agency in the United States now. That tells you the importance of a resume. I think I proved my point, right? It's not about that. You got to sense the energy of a person and what they want to help you with and how they feel about being a part of something special. Once you figure that out, then you can bring them in. You're looking for members that have a commitment to the concept of working as a team. They don't want to come here. Yeah, I just want to come and learn. And I want to build my own business in 3 months. And maybe I just learn enough and I can go and leave you. And then I can go and build my own business. You don't want that. Now, is it going to happen down the line? The people are going to come and steal your systems? It's happened to me. Like I literally have had people that I trusted come in here, learn everything that I know, all the systems, quit, talk to a client and tell them that they can actually do it for like 30% of what I'm charging them and stealing a client. That has happened to me. I'm talking about true life horror stories. It's inevitable. There are people out there that are not right. It's going to happen. So is it going to be like a pretty experience all the time recruiting people? No, it wouldn't be business. It's not what our job looks like, right? It's all part of the world that we live in. And you got to just be okay with that. And you got to build systems to help you deal with those things along the way. All right. It's all part of it. The more hoops that you create, the better systems. Something that I can tell you right now, when somebody joins my agency, they have to sign a non-compete and they have to sign a non-disclosure agreement. All right. So if you want to work with my agency, you're not going to steal my clients, all right, when you quit, because otherwise I'm going to go after you, right? And so we built that from experience along the way. So you want to look for that. So where can you find best people to hire? Well, there's a lot of options right there. And you can look for these people on board. Like the one thing that I told you guys about FreeUp is that you cannot really build a team with these guys. FreeUp owns them, not you. It's a very similar to 24/7 VA, they kind of own the person, but you can actually bring them in. So that's why online jobs PH is one of my favorite ones. And Facebook ads is the other one of my favorite ones. So how to post for job vacancies? We do things like this. You can go ahead and grab a template like the one that we have over here. We're looking for Facebook ad experts like you. Everybody go to Marketing Ninja, join our team, qualifications. And then we have those things in place. And we're looking for some of these experts to bring them in. And then you can have the ones like on the right, pictures of my staff's in the Philippines. This is what we're looking for. Video editors, Google PPC specialists, Amazon specialists, graphic designers, web development and funnel experts, Facebook ad managers. And then you can send an email to Jen at AGM Agency. In this game, we also promote HR at AGM Agency. So you can create ads like this. Very simple. The one thing that I like the most is that you put the leader in front of the camera and you create videos and then you can promote that. Like I did the interview with Jonald and we got a lot of applications from that. I also did a video myself promoting the opportunity, and then we run Facebook ads and we bring people into the funnel. So as I mentioned a couple of times, most important positions everyone needs to hire in order to expand: graphic artists, designers, Amazon Seller Central specialists, Facebook ad managers, ManyChat experts. If they're not experts, guess what? You can get them trained, and that's going to tell you if they have the basic quality to be able to help you in that area. You bring them in, you have them do module 11, and you have them build out some flows and some funnels, and then you have them send you some test preview links so you can see what they did and see if they have some native skills. That's just the way that these guys have started. I mean, Jonald with me a couple of years ago, I didn't know he had any skill. I started hearing from Jorge, oh, Jonald is so good. He's really good at this. He's really good at that. And I'm like, And I eventually stole him from Jorge and I took him into my team and then I never sent him back. So you can discover slowly what are these guys' skill and if they can help you just by giving them some training. And the great news is that you guys have the training to give them already. And here's a mind map that we built on the hiring process. Okay, so here's how it starts. Decide where you need help. All right, first step, list down your requirements. Advertise job application, receive job applications and pre-qualify, schedule interviews, and then unqualified. Okay, good. So then you're going to determine if they're unqualified or qualified. If they are qualified, you give them a job offer and you give them a 2 weeks trial. And on that 2 weeks trial, you're going to find out if they can help you or not. It's going to cost you a few hundred dollars. And then you're going to find out if they have some special skills, if they have talent, if they can actually take training and do things. You guys know that a lot of the things that I've done in my agency, I don't have a clue how to do. I don't know 2% what Dolph knows how to do. A lot of the things that Rain does in customer service, I don't. I bring them in and I train them, and sometimes they figure things out along the way, and then they do things better than me. It's all part of the process. They pass a 2-week trial, and then I make them into a regular staff. They didn't pass a trial, then off we go, right? We go back to scheduling more interviews and continuing down the funnel. So that's basically how we have it all set up if you guys want to repeat your own process along the way.